My name is Jonathan Pope, and I go to Westminster Christian Academy, and we're the Cyborg Cats. My interest in robotics came around when I was about 9 years old, and I was just really interested in electronics and RC cars and just any mechanisms that you can take apart. Most of them, you'd have to rip them apart so you couldn't put them back together. But I would end up with a bunch of pieces, and through the years I would put those pieces together to make stuff, and that kind of thing helped me understand a little bit more about mechanisms and how they can be used. So my confidence in like building things grew, and I became more aware of my interest in robotics and that I wanted to pursue it.
Tell me a little bit about how you started to bring robotics into your school environment.
Yeah, I guess it originated just from expressing my interest to Ms. Harding about robotics and cool things that were going on in the scientific world and engineering. And just I would just spend some lunch periods just watching cool YouTube videos in Ms. Harding's classroom, and it's cool to everyone, so there it built up interest. And luckily, Ms. Harding was able to sponsor, be a teacher sponsor for the Junior Engineering and Technological Society branch at our school, because we were just interested in forming a community of students that were interested in science and other tech subjects that weren't interested in doing AV club, because at that point that was all that was available.
Were you surprised at how many kids kind of became interested and started participating in science club?
Yeah, I was surprised at who and how many there were, because I learned that some surprising personalities and friends of mine actually had a sincere interest in robotics or just technology in general. And some people who would never even talk about it or anything, they were interested in it and they would come. And it obviously made me really happy, because then there's I know that there's a community to talk to and to share information with. And that's really cool and encouraging, because I guess learning about like new technology, it's not like a class or anything like that. You have to like read about it, popular science and stuff like that. And so having a community to talk to about it and share ideas is kind of like learning about new things all the time without a teacher explaining it. And it's kind of cool, because kids would be talking about complicated ideas or like new techniques in like medicine, even though they just like read about it, so it's kind of neat.
And so it sounds like before you guys even heard about FIRST, you were sort of doing FIRST like competitions within the science club. Tell me kind of how that developed.
Yeah, in the fall of 2011, in anticipation for the FRC season, should we have gotten the scholarship, we ordered 2 Tektrix kits and organized several challenges that we would divide the engineering team to tackle with the kits. So there'd be a team of about 6 or so kids, and they'd have a Tektrix kit, and there's 2 motors and 2 servos in each kit, and a motor controller, and several other pieces. It's basically like Legos, but they're metal, and you can make a little bit more sturdy and complex mechanisms out of them. And we use that to tackle challenges to get people mechanically competent and ready for FRC.
So using CAD software like NX and now being involved with this robotics competition, I know it's really early still, but you know, what do you think you want to do when you're older?
Well, I definitely want to do... Well, robotics or mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, which is robotics is kind of mechanical engineering and electrical engineering. But one thing I've been thinking about lately is basically the idea of innovation. Like, I like coming up with like solutions to problems. What I want to do is be an Imagineer, because those guys get to opportunity to be really creative.